great pleasure in welcoming the Prime Minister of the Republic of India, His Excellency Narendra Modi, and I invite him to address the Assembly. Mr. Prime Minister.
It was a historic day when Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed the United Nations General Assembly. The world decided to honor the glorious practice of yoga by giving it formal international recognition.
Yoga hamari purantan paramparik amulya den hai. Yoga man va sharir vichar va karma sanyam va uplabdhi ki ekatmata ka tatha manav va prakruti ke beech samanjas ka murt roop hai. Yeh swasth va kalyan ka समग्र दृष्टिकोण है योग केवल व्यायाम भर न होकर अपने आप से तथा विश्व व प्रकृति के साथ तादात्म्य को प्राप्त करने का माध्यम है यह हमारी जीवन शैली में परिवर्तन लाकर तथा हम में जागरूकता उत्पन्न करके जलवायु परिवर्तन से लड़ने में सहायक हो सकता है आइए हम एक अंतर्राष्ट्रीय योग दिवस को आरंभ करने की दिशा में कार्य करें
मुझे बहुत प्रसन्नता है कि भारत की पहल पर 21 जून का दिन अंतर्राष्ट्रीय योग दिवस के रूप में घोषित किया गया 27 सितंबर 2014 को भारत के प्रधानमंत्री ने संयुक्त राष्ट्र संघ की आम सभा को संबोधित करते हुए ये चाहा था कि 21 जून को अंतर्राष्ट्रीय दिवस के रूप में मनाया जाना चाहिए मात्र 75 दिनों में 177 देशों के सहसंयोजक बनकर ये प्रस्ताव पारित हुआ और ये अपने आप में एक नया कीर्तिमान बना कि 177 देश सह प्रायोजक बने योग केवल व्यायाम नहीं है योग एक तनावग्रस्त व्यक्ति का तनाव वापस लेता है दूर करके उसे तनाव रहित बनाता है योग अशांत मन को शांत करता है इसलिए आइए हम सब योग को अपनाएं अपना मन भी शांत करें और विश्व शांति के मार्ग पर आगे बढ़ें
योग भारत की सांस्कृतिक विरासत है हजारों वर्ष पूर्व हमारे पूर्वजों द्वारा मानव शरीर मस्तिष्क एवं आत्मा के समग्र उत्थान हेतु योग पद्धति और साधना का विकास किया गया है आज योग पूरे विश्व में फैल रहा है और इसके विस्तार के पीछे अनेक योग गुरुओं का योगदान रहा है योग के द्वारा पूरे विश्व में लोग आरोग्यवर्धक और रोग निदान का लाभ उठा रहे हैं विश्व योग दिवस के सफल आयोजन हेतु मेरी शुभकामनाएं
Yoga is essentially a spiritual discipline based on extremely subtle science. It is an art and science for healthy living. The word yoga is derived from the Sanskrit word yug, meaning to join or unite. According to yogic scriptures, the practice of yoga leads to the union of the individual consciousness with that of the universal consciousness, indicating a perfect balance between mind and body, man and nature. The science of yoga has its origins thousands of years ago, before the first religions or belief systems were born. In yogic lore, Shiv, the first yogi or Adi Yogi, transmitted his profound knowledge to his seven disciples, the famous Saptarishis or the seven sages. Yoga was practiced through the pre-Vedic period. But it was Maharishi Patanjali, known as the father of modern yoga, who systematized and codified the then practices through his Yoga Sutras. Later, many yoga masters contributed to the preservation and development of yoga and the spreading of this wonderful practice. There are different schools of yoga. These include Jnana Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Karma Yoga, Patanjala Yoga, Hatha Yoga, Kundalini Yoga, Dhyana Yoga, Mantra Yoga, Laya Yoga, Jaina Yoga, Bodha Yoga, etc. Each school has its own approach and practices that lead to the ultimate aims and objectives of yoga. Some of the widely practiced yoga sadhanas are Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi, Bandha and Mudra, Shatkarmas, Yuktahara, Mantra Japa, Yuktakarma. A yoga practitioner should follow the guiding principles while performing yogic practices. Before practice, yogic practice should be performed in a calm and quiet atmosphere with a relaxed body and mind. It should be done on an empty stomach or light stomach. Consume a small amount of honey in lukewarm water if you feel weak. Light and comfortable cotton clothes are preferred to facilitate easy movement of the body. In case of chronic diseases or pain or cardiac problems, a physician or a yoga therapist should be consulted prior to performing yogic practices. During practice, practice sessions should start with a prayer or invocation, as it creates a conducive environment to relax the mind. Yogic practices shall be performed slowly, in a relaxed manner, with awareness of the body and breath. Do not hold the breath, unless it is specially mentioned to do so. Do not hold the body tightly or jerk the body. Perform the practices according to your own capacity. End the session with deep silence or Shanti Path. Food or a bath may be taken only 20 to 30 minutes after practice. Welcome to the world of yoga. Welcome to the world of wisdom that is as relevant and beneficial today as it was thousands of years ago.
Sanjana na upasate.
Welcome to the world of yoga. Let us start yoga sadhana with chalana kriyas or loosening practices to increase microcirculation. Neck exercises, forward and backward neck bending. Stand in an alert posture. Keep feet comfortably apart and your arms on the waist. Exhale and bend head forward slowly and try to touch the chin to the chest. Inhale, move the head as far back as is comfortable and come back with inhalation. Right and left neck bending. Exhale, bend the head slowly to the right. Bring the ear as close as possible to the shoulder. Inhale, bring the head to normal position. Exhale, bend the head to the left side. Inhale, bring the head up to normal position. Right and left twisting. Exhale, gently turn the head to the right side so that the chin is in line with the shoulder. Inhale, bring the head to the normal position. Exhale, turn the head to the left side. Inhale and bring the head to the normal position. Neck rotation. Bend the head forward, trying to touch the chin to the chest. Inhale, slowly rotate the head clockwise. While coming down, exhale. Rotate the head in anti-clockwise direction. Feel the stretch around the neck and loosening up of the joints and muscles of the neck and release of tension in the neck. People with neck pain and spondylitis should do the practice gently. Trunk twisting. Keep the legs about 2 feet apart. Raise both the arms up to chest level with the palms facing each other. Exhale. Twist the body towards the right side so that the left palm touches the right shoulder. Come back with inhalation. Now, exhale, twist the body towards the left side so that the right palm touches the left shoulder. Come back with inhalation. Repeat, do slowly with breathing. Avoid this practice in case of vertebral and disc disorders and during menstruation. Relax in standing posture. Knee movements. Inhale, lift your arms up at the shoulder level. Exhale, bend the knees and bring down your body to the squatting position. Inhale and straighten the body. Repeat 2 more times. This practice strengthens the knees and hip joints. Avoid this in case suffering from acute arthritis. Exhale while bringing down the hands. Now, let us move to yogasana. Taadasana. Taad means palm tree. Keep your feet 2 inches apart. Interlock the fingers and turn the wrist outwards. Inhale, raise the arms up and bring them in line with the shoulders. Raise the heels off the floor and balance on the toes. Stay in this position for 10 to 15 seconds. This asana brings stability in the body, helps to clear up congestion of the spinal nerves, corrects faulty posture. Exhale, bring the heels down. Release the interlock of the fingers and bring the arms down parallel to the trunk and come back to a standing posture. Vrikshasana.